Peter learned that lesson the hard way in today's passage. He had an image of Jesus crafted in his head of a military victor who would raise up a violent coup to overthrow their Roman oppressors. And in Peter's defense, he certainly wasn't the only one with those hopes. He, as we've come to expect with Peter, was just the first person to open his mouth and spit out what he was thinking. And Jesus doesn't take the bait. He rebukes Peter in a particularly harsh fashion. But the severity of his rebuke is simply evidence, I think, of just how much is at stake for Jesus and his ministry. Jesus led a decidedly nonviolent movement, and an unapologetically political one at that. One that challenged the Roman Empire, a patriarchal and violent institution ruled by military dominance. Jesus, in rebuking Peter's suggestion, is refusing to become exactly that which he is opposing.